Hi, I'm Jessie Moan with the University of Alaska Fairbanks Cooperative Extension Services Integrated Pest Management Program. Today, we're going to go over how to evaluate a dead spruce tree to determine if it has spruce beetles in it and why it's important to evaluate these trees. This information can be applied to individual trees in ornamental settings or to small woodlots or a larger forest setting.
This video is part of a series, so be sure to check out our videos on how to identify the signs and symptoms of spruce beetle and how to process infested material for more information on those topics. Trees that have been killed by spruce beetle can support beetle life stages for roughly 2 years after they have died, so it is important to know what to look for and what to do with infested dead trees to minimize the spruce beetle risk to standing live trees in the area. The most important thing to look for is spruce beetle life stages underneath the bark. The best way to do this is to peel a section of the bark off and look for beetle life stages. When looking under the bark for spruce beetle life stages, we are primarily looking for larvae, or the immature stage, pupae, the life stage that is undergoing transition to adulthood, and adults. Eggs are very small and less likely to be seen. It is also important to note that there will likely be a lot of other living things underneath the bark of the tree. Spruce beetle larvae are small, creamy white, and legless. Larvae are responsible for the majority of damage caused by spruce beetle. They may have an orangish-brown head and are overall grub-like in appearance. Pupae are also creamy white in color, but do not completely resemble either the larvae or adult beetles, though they are similar in overall size and shape to adults. The pupae are a non-feeding, non-mobile life stage. Adults are reddish-brown to black in color and about a quarter of an inch long and cylindrical in shape. Finding individuals of these life stages means there's a possibility that beetles could emerge to infest standing live trees in the area. Infested trees may be prioritized for removal to help reduce beetle populations and protect surrounding trees. Having a general idea for how long the tree has been dead is also important so that the proper precautions are taken when removing trees. A tree that has long since been killed by beetles does not necessarily need to be removed, since once the inner bark of a tree has substantially dried out, spruce beetles are no longer able to survive in the material. However, these trees may become a health or safety hazard as they age. The length of time a tree remains standing after it dies from beetle attack is highly variable. Environmental factors, such as precipitation and humidity, can influence how fast a tree decomposes and therefore how unstable it becomes. If the tree shows obvious signs of rot or is in danger of crushing infrastructure if it fell, it may be best to remove it as soon as possible. Cutting or felling trees can be dangerous. Make sure to take proper safety precautions and wear all personal protective equipment. If you do not have experience operating a chainsaw, it may be best to hire a professional instead. Removing infested trees can help manage future populations of beetles and protect surrounding live trees, as long as the material is processed correctly. Under some circumstances, trees may be removed to prevent them from becoming a health or safety hazard to people or structures. The best time to fell an actively infested tree is fall or winter. This is when beetles are least likely to be active and will still allow plenty of time to process the felled material. Avoid cutting trees between May and July during the active beetle flight period, as fresh cut material is attractive to beetles. If necessary, trees can be cut in early spring, but it is important that the material is processed promptly. After the tree has been felled, remove the branches. The trunk and any branches greater than 5 inches in diameter should be processed to minimize the possibility of adult beetles emerging. Stumps should be cut as low to the ground as possible. The best option is to grind out the stump or debark it to 2 inches below the soil line. Removing infested trees from a property can be beneficial in reducing spruce beetle populations in the immediate area. Check your trees for spruce beetle life stages to help determine if the tree should be removed and avoid felling spruce trees between May and July. Felled trees should be processed in such a way that prevents adult beetles from emerging from the cut tree and prevents attracting new beetles to the freshly cut tree.
Knowing what to do about a dead spruce tree is an important step in making spruce beetle management decisions. For more information on processing material, see our video on processing. For more information on spruce beetles and spruce beetle management, visit www.alaskaSpruceBeetle.org.